Today in Texas, SpaceX launched the largest rocket ever built. The Starship did not make it back to Earth, but that doesn't mean today was a loss. West 2's space expert Scott Heidler is joining us live tonight, taking a deeper dive into these missions. And Scott, this is the third test flight. SpaceX is calling it a success, but the Starship was destroyed. What are the big achievements that make it a success?
Right, it's kind of tough to really wrap your brain around the idea that it was all destroyed, but it was a success. What we're looking at is that it went further than the past two tests. And it, I mean, both, it has two main components, the booster stage, the super heavy booster, 33 engines. And then you've got the Starship itself at the very top that also has its own engines. The two previous tests, none of it made it up to where it was supposed to be. The booster didn't go as high as it was supposed to, nor did the Starship. It didn't even make it into orbit. This time it made it into orbit. And obviously that's a very critical test for this spaceship because it just had never made it into space before. So once it did get up there, they were able to test the cargo bay door. They were able to do a fuel transfer test and then do some other testing for it. But then also a big issue is how it re-entered the Earth's atmosphere after this partial orbit, if you will. And that's where, unfortunately, it broke apart essentially just before it was supposed to splash down in the Indian Ocean. But all this data is going to be data. Most of this data is going to be information that SpaceX didn't have in these last two missions, particularly the fact that it actually made it up into space. So that's what they're really focused on when it comes to the success out of this morning's test flight.
And we know this isn't going to be the last test flight. So what areas do they need to focus on for test flight number four?
Couple of areas. Let's start with Starship. That, you know, again, that's just the very top part. That's the part that NASA is very interested in. That's going to be the lunar lander. That's going to transport the first people back to the lunar surface in more than 50 years, hopefully in 2 years. Let's focus on that. That, everything seemed to go pretty well. There was a little bit of a question about if and how and when they were going to test its engines. So that's something obviously they had issue with or had more needed more information. But then more importantly is it disintegrated when it was going through at a stage when it was going through re-entry. And that's for any spacecraft re-entering Earth's atmosphere, that's a very delicate process. This didn't have any people on it. This didn't have any satellites on it. So there was nothing lost in this. And the way NASA looks at it and other customers for SpaceX looks at it, they just want Starship to carry things it or other things further away. So I guess for them, it's less of a concern. For SpaceX, it's a bigger concern because they want to make this, the idea of when they made this is it to be reusable. So if it breaks up on reentry, that's a big issue. For the big, big booster itself, that corrected itself. This is going to be like how we have Falcon 9 rockets come down and land. This was just going to test land, soft land in the Gulf of Mexico. It landed where they thought it was going to be, but it wasn't so soft. So that's also what they need to look at. It looks like it was directionally controlled well. It's just being able to decelerate. That's where the issue was with that major booster.
And Scott, why is Starship so critical to the return to the moon and the NASA program? And also, what does this mean for us and operations on the Cape?
Well, I alluded to it there. You know, this is commissioned to be the lander for the Artemis program, Artemis 3, that's supposed to be in 2026, projected to be 2026. This is going to be the craft that brings astronauts will go to the moon, orbit the moon in Orion, and then Starship will ferry them down to the lunar surface, back and forth. It'll be there and just ferry the astronauts back and forth. Outside of that, it's also going to be used as an orbiting fuel station, if you will. That's why they did this fuel testing today. That's because there'll be a Starship up in Earth's orbit. It'll refuel other starships that will then go further afield to the moon, obviously, initially, and then the hopes are to Mars. So it's a bit of a building block, a very important building block for the deep space exploration that NASA's doing with commercial partners. So that's why it's very critical. And all that is critical to us here on the Space Coast, because once it becomes operational, once it's beyond this test phase, it's going to launch from here out at the Cape. And they've already started to build out the pad for it here. So you know, you can imagine the infrastructure, human and physical infrastructure, SpaceX, NASA, other entities that are going to need to be built up once it becomes operational. Because once it does, there are going to have to be a lot of launches to get all that material up there, up around Earth's orbit, and then around the moon's orbit before then they can land and then go further afield into Mars.
It is all such exciting stuff, and it's fascinating. Thank you for explaining it to us and breaking it down in terms we can understand, Scott. Thank you for your time tonight.